Hey everyone, how are you all? I hope that you are doing fine and preparing really hard for your examination. And in order to aid your preparation, I have brought to you this video of Morning Tales that is going to help you in covering the daily current affairs that can be asked in your RBS Heavy and ABAD examination. So without wasting any time, let's begin the video. But before that, if you haven't subscribed our channel, guys, then do so. And you can also join this Telegram group where you will get the PDF of this session. The link of this Telegram group is in description below. So guys, this is our first question. With which of the following institution has Indian Institute of Space Science and Technology collaborated to develop the InspireSat-1 CubeSat? So this is basically a satellite that has been developed by this institution in collaboration with one of the institutions from the options. So let's have a look at the options first and then we will know the answer of this question. So the very first option is Laboratory for Atmospheric and Space Physics. Option B is National Center University. Option C is Nanyang Technological University. Option D, both A and B. And option E is all A, B and C. So here the right answer is option E. That is, all these three organizations have collaborated with this Indian Institution of Space Science and Technology to launch and develop this InspireSat-1 CubeSat. So basically this satellite is going to research or study the Earth's ionosphere, and it is going to be launched on a PSLV mission. Right now, the details related to its launch have not been revealed, but definitely it is going to be launched very soon because the launch date of this mission was 2020, but due to the COVID, it has been postponed. So it is going to launch very soon. But for the timing, you need to know the details that have been revealed related to this Inspire satellite. So this is how this satellite looks. Now, this Laboratory of Atmospheric and Science Physics is a part of University of Colorado, Boulder in US. National Central University is a university of Taiwan, whereas this Nanyang Technology University is a university in Singapore. Your responsibility is to remember all the countries as well, because in the name of the universities, we are collaborating with the countries only. Okay, so this is a mark of India's collaboration with other countries in the field of science and technology, or space to be more precise. INSPIRE stands for International Satellite Program in Research and Education. So this is basically a program under which this SAT-1 CubeSat has been developed, and more satellites will be developed soon. So a constellation of Earth and space weather observation satellites are being planned under this INSPIRE program only. Okay, so this satellite, as far as this satellite is concerned, this CubeSat is going to study the Earth's ionosphere, and this is an additional point that the students of IIST got the opportunity to attend the training at this institution as part of this collaboration for developing this cube satellite. I hope that this question is clear to you. Now let's move on to the next question. In which of the following university is All India Institute of Ayurveda setting up the academic chair in Ayurveda? Columbia University, California Institute of Technology, Yale University, Western Sydney University, or University of Michigan. So out of these options, the right answer is option D, Western Sydney University, which is located in Australia. With this university, the All India Institute of Ayurveda has signed an MOU to establish this Ayurvedic chair of academic chair in Ayurveda. Now, the basic purpose of this chair would be to enhance research in the field of Ayurveda and herbal medicines and yoga as well. Also, this chair will undertake research and programs that can enhance the knowledge of Australian students in the field of Ayurveda. Okay, so these are the two purposes: extending the research and creating awareness about Ayurveda yoga and herbal medicines among the students of this university. Okay, now let's have a deeper look into this news. So these are the activities that will be undertaken by the academic chair in Ayurveda. And this point is very important, guys, because this is stating that the whole university is not going to set up this Ayurvedic chair. The NICM, Health Research Institute, which is located inside this Western Sydney University, or we can say which is a part of this university, is going to set up this Ayurvedic academic chair. Now, this initiative is going to be jointly funded by the Ministry of Ayush and Western Sydney University, and it is anticipated to commence operations by 2022. Not an important point, but this point is important, that this collaboration or this MOU will remain in existence for 3 years. Okay, so I hope that this is clear. Now let's move on to the next question. What is the maximum financial ceiling on purchase of equipment by vice chiefs of the services as per the Delegation of Financial Powers to Defence Services 2021? So this is basically a framework that has been unveiled or recently launched by the Ministry of Defence that defines the powers of armed forces in relation to the acquiring of equipments. Okay, so how much financial freedom do these forces have when it comes to the acquisition of equipments? This is something that is revealed by this framework. Okay, the one thing is clear, that the financial powers delegated to the armed forces is revealed in this framework. The another important point that is revealed in this framework is leasing the equipments on short term. So basically, defense acquisition procedure of 2022. So if you haven't covered those procedures, the guidelines that were released last year in relation to the acquisition of defense equipments, then you need to cover this. So watch it after this video. We have prepared a special video on this as well. Okay, so this framework introduced the leasing of equipments for a shorter period of time, because if we lease out the borrow the equipments for a shorter period of time, then it will reduce our cost as well as delays in the acquisition of defense goods, and it will help in the battlefield. Okay, so these are the two main points that have been introduced in this framework. First, the financial limit of the chiefs that has been assigned, and second, that it has allowed basically or reaffirmed that you can lease the equipments for a shorter period of time. Now let's have a look at the limit, the financial limit that is allowed to the vice chiefs of each armed forces. So the answer is this: 500 crores is the maximum financial cap that has been set on the vice chiefs of these forces, and the similar financial limit is also there for the chief of defense staff and for the chief of all these staff, chief of the committee of these staff. Okay, now other thing that I wanted to tell you about this framework is that the last time that this framework was released was in 2016. Okay, so that was an additional point. Where will the Union Ministry of Ports, Shipping and Waterways set up the Skill Institute on Marine Studies under the Indian Maritime University? Meerut, Kanpur, Jaipur, Guwahati, Dispur. The right answer is Guwahati in Assam. Okay, now this is located in Chennai. So basically, this university is going to administer the operations of this Skill Institute that will be set up in Guwahati, Assam. Okay, apart from this, there is nothing much that you need to know. With which Gulf Cooperation Council's country has India signed an MOU to establish the visiting professorship in social science initiative in the other nation? So what this initiative is all about that we will be discussing. But let's first know the answer of this question. UAE, Oman, Qatar, Bahrain, Kuwait are in the options, out of which UAE is the right answer. So India and UAE have both signed this MOU, and on behalf of India, Indian Council for Cultural Relations, and on behalf of UAE, New York University, Abu Dhabi, both of these organizations have signed this MOU. Now, this MOU will facilitate the members, the faculty members from Indian University to go in UAE's this university, New York University, Abu Dhabi, and teach the students there. So this is basically providing an opportunity to the faculty members of Indian universities, okay, in the field of social science. I hope that this is clear. Now, visiting professorship in social science. Social science is the discipline. Visiting professorship means that the professor will visit from another country for a tenure of 6 to 10 months. Okay, this is also written here. 6 to 10 months every year for undertaking research and teaching social sciences in Abu Dhabi. Now, this university is a portal campus of New York University, serving as a private liberal arts college in Abu Dhabi. So this is basically a branch of New York University, this Abu Dhabi University. Now, guys, I mentioned Gulf Cooperation Council. Can you tell me the names of the countries which are members of GCC? It is mentioned in this picture only, but I would like to hear from you in the comment section below the names of GCC members. As far as UAE is concerned, so this is UAE. This is the Gulf of Aden near Yemen. Here, recently India and German Navy is conducted their exercise. So this exercise is very recent and it took place in the Gulf of Aden near Yemen. Do remember this thing, and do not forget to mention the member countries of GCC, Gulf Cooperation Council. Which of the following organization has launched My eHeart portal to empower artisans and strengthen the value chain of handicraft sector in the country? Infosys, Mahindra & Mahindra, Tata Chemicals, HCL Foundation, NSE Foundation. The right answer is HCL Foundation, and this portal is a part of CSR of this organization. Okay? Corporate social responsibility. Now, guys, under this portal, basically the basic function of this portal will be to onboard the artisans on this platform so that they can sell their handicraft and their products on this portal. And the very basic and peculiar feature of this portal is that this is going to connect the artisans with the consumers directly. Usually the platforms like Amazon do not connect the artisans with the consumers. We are connected with the Amazon platform, not the direct artisans, but this platform will connect the artisans with the consumers themselves. So this is going to increase the market access of the artisans. Okay, so that is the basic purpose of this My eHeart portal. Now, guys, I wrote here CSR. So you would know that the government has mandated every company in India to follow the 2% CSR obligation if it fulfills either of the criterias from these three criterias: net worth, turnover, or profit. There are certain threshold limits of all of these criterias. You have to tell me the threshold limit that a company, if any company fulfills or goes beyond that threshold limit, that then the company has to fulfill the CSR obligation. So your responsibility is to tell me that limit. Okay, this limit is very important. This is a part of your basic banking awareness. Okay, so do tell me in the comment section below. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज विच ऑफ द फॉलोइंग इज द एंसेस्ट्रल विलेज ऑफ फॉर्मर इंडियन प्राइम मिनिस्टर पीवी नरसिम्हा राव विच इज बीइंग टर्न्ड इनटू अ टूरिस्ट साइट ऑन द 100th एनिवर्सरी ऑफ पीवी नरसिम्हा राव. सो यू हैव ऑल द ऑप्शंस एंड आउट ऑफ दीज ऑप्शंस द राइट आंसर इज वनग्रा विच इज इन तेलंगाना. If you know, guys, P.V. Narasimha Rao was the first non-Hindi speaking person who became the Prime Minister of India. Also, he was the first from the South India to become the Prime Minister of India. And recently, this year is the 100th birth anniversary of this person, of P.V. Narasimha Rao, who has been the former Prime Minister of India. And on that occasion, the village of this person, Telangana government has announced that this village will be turned into a tourist site and the home of P.V. Narasimha Rao will be turned into a museum. So that was the news. Now you need to remember the name, the state. Okay. So guys, that was all. Do not forget to mention your answers in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching the video.